My name is Matt Keller and I'm a digital artist from Mexico. On this tutorial, I'll teach you how to create a pumpkin illustration in Adobe Photoshop. The first thing we're going to do is create a new document, so just go File, New, and make sure that you create the document that is 800 by 600 pixels and it has a resolution of 72 pixels per inch. So once you do that, just create your new document and you're going to be ready. The first thing we're going to do is change the color of the background. So to do that, I'm going to double click right here and then pick a color. I had already selected a color to save time. It's this color, but feel free to pick whatever color works for you. Now I'm going to go to my paint bucket tool or press the shortcut G and just paint it. And you can see that now my background is purple. I'm going to find my tools, my shape tool, sorry. And I'm going to find the ellipse tool, so just click on that one and you see that you have the rest of the tools right there. So for now we're going to be using the ellipse tool. And now if I click on that one and press shift, you can see how I can make a circle. So I'm going to do that. And this window, the properties window, is going to appear. And if that doesn't happen, just remember that you can go to window properties to have that same window. Now in here I can change the color, so I'm going to change my fill for this orange and I'm going to change my stroke to this other orange and change the width to 5 pixels. Now in here I can also change my width and my height, so I'm going to do that. I'm going to change it to 247. And now I can just simply move it to the center, and if you're using this latest version, it's going to snap. Otherwise, just select both of them and go on the top to align vertical and horizontally. Now that you have done this, make sure that you select your ellipse tool. And while you use the move tool, just press Alt and Shift. And if you can see that, now I'm making a copy, but I'm also constraining the movement to one axis. I'm gonna take the copy below my ellipse so I can see it just like this. And I'm gonna again press Alt and Shift on the other side to create the other side of my pumpkin. Make sure that you may move both of them to the same distance. And with this, we have the shape of our pumpkin. Now I'm gonna go to my ellipse tool and create another one. This one is going to have a width of 317 by a height of 42. And now let's remove the stroke, because I don't need it, by clicking here on this diagonal and change the color to a darker purple. Now I'm going to go to my move tool, press B on my keyboard and move it below my pumpkin, just like that. I'm going to zoom in by pressing Ctrl Plus and finding my pen tool by clicking here or pressing the P on my keyboard. Make a point, then make another point, and while you click, also drag a little bit to make a curve. Now if I just click there and you see how I have that tangency, to break it, all I'm going to do is press Alt and click on that last point, and that way I can make it more of a straight line. Then I'm going to make another point, click and drag a little bit and just close it, remove the stroke, or actually change the color to this brown for the fill and change the stroke color to this darker brown. Now I'm going to take that shape one and take it below my ellipses. Move it right there to the center, and next I'm going to create another ellipse. So I'm just going to create one and I'm going to change the width and the height to 90 by 35. And again, change the fill and the color to a green and a darker green that I had already selected. As I said, feel free to pick your colors or use similar as the ones that I'm using. I'm going to go to my direct selection tool, going right there, pressing A on my keyboard. And what I'm going to do is move one on the handles on the anchor point. It's going to give me a warning that this is not going to be any more an ellipse. That's okay, because I want the round part to be more like that. I'm going to move it. Then I'm going to press Ctrl T to bring the transformation. Move the anchor point a little bit and rotate it right there. Now I'm going to take that ellipse and take it behind the shape that we created with our pen tool. I'm going to go to the top and create another ellipse, just make it right there. I'm going to remove the stroke and change the fill to white. And this one, I'm going to make it 66 by 66. If I click right there on the middle, I can constrain the value, so both of them are going to change if I change one. I'm going to create another circle just by clicking right there. And I'm going to change this one to 38 by 38 and change the color to a darker purple. I'm going to move this to be inside my white eye. And you can see how we are having the eyes for our pumpkin. Now I want to create a little shape. So I'm going to go to my rounded rectangle and just create one. And now here again, just remember that I can change the values. So I can go to something that is 50 by 15. And I can leave it as it is. Just make sure that you move it in place by dragging a little bit to the center. Select both shapes, go to layer, and you're going to find combined shapes right there. And then you're going to go to subtract from shape. If you click on that one, you're going to see how that shape on the front has been deleted, and that's exactly what we want, so it's going fine. You can undo that by pressing Ctrl C and play around a little bit with the rounded rectangle. So let's change that one to 13, so something like that. And again, if I select both shapes and go combine shapes, subtract from the shape, you can see how I get that result. Now I'm going to select both of them, and while pressing Alt and Shift, I'm going to move them to the right to create a copy, just like that. I can select the four of those layers and drag them to this little folder icon right here in my layers window. And if I do that, I am grouping them, and I can double click where it says group one to rename it and type eyes. Now what I can do is align them as well. So you could align them manually or click right here on the top while you are selecting the shapes that you need to align. So next I'm going to create my eyebrow. So I'm going to go to my rounded rectangle tool and just create one. Change the width to 40 and the height to 10. I'm going to change the roundness. You can do it right here. 5.5, I think it's okay. I'm going to remove the stroke and change the color of the fill to a darker orange. I'm going to press Alt and Shift to create and copy, but first I'm going to press Ctrl T to rotate it. And if I rotate it like that, it's going to be 30 degrees. Now I can make a copy by pressing Alt and Shift, then go Ctrl T to bring that one, right click, and go Flip Horizontal. And that way I can have another eyebrow. I'm going to drag them and group them. And I'm going to call these eyebrows. And just position them where you need them. So this is completely up to you. And finally, we're going to create them out. So to do that, we're going to use... we're going to go and use an ellipse. So click on the ellipse tool and let's make one. Again, I'm going to remove the stroke because I don't need it for this one. Change the color to the fill to a darker purple. And now let's change the values to something that is smaller. So 20 by 23. And now let's just move it to the center. That's okay. I can press Alt and Shift when I am done positioning. And when I do that, I'm going to create a copy. I'm going to change the color of that shape. So I'm going to go here and change the fill to this lighter purple. And if I click between both layers while press Alt, you can see how I get that little arrow. I'm going to mask that top layer inside the first ellipse. So with that, I have my expression. I can select all of them and group them. Everything that is my face and call this expression. And now if I zoom out a little bit by pressing Ctrl minus, you can see how it's happening. And if I go and drop that folder into the new ledger, I can make a copy. You can see how now this is expression copy. And if I turn off the visibility of both, you can see how I have everything just there. So I'm going to make some modifications to this one. First, I'm going to remove them out. I'm going to go to my pen tool or press P on my keyboard and just make a point, make another point and drag a little bit so I can create a little smile. I'm going to remove the fill because I don't need it. The stroke is fine. And go here to the line, go to caps and make sure that you select a rounded cap to get something like this. Now, if you want to select it, go to your direct selection tool or press A on your keyboard and always change the stroke width to something around 5. So just remember that type the number and then hit enter. And now you have a pumpkin that is smiling. Just move it a little bit below. And if you toggle the visibility between the expression and the copy, you get a smile. I'm going to double click on the name. Let's call this a smile. Now I'm going to call the first one Boo. This is kind of making Boo. Make a copy of that Boo expression. And now let's open it. Now let's have our eyebrows. Press Ctrl T and just rotate it. Rotate them. Now if I toggle the visibility of the one below, you can see that now the eyebrows are pointing down. Now I'm going to go to my direct selection tool and go on my lips. And what I can do is move around the anchor point. So if I move this one a little bit below, and remember that you're going to get that warning telling you that this is not anymore a shape. That's okay, because right now you want to transform that ellipse. So it's not anymore a shape. So just move the anchor points a little bit and then go to the ellipse copy. Ctrl T to transform it and just made it a little bit wider. And with that we have a different expression. Now it's a little bit different with different eyebrows. And what we can do is go to our type tool, press T, and let's change the color to white. And now let's type Happy Halloween. Just as a title. Let's change the to 36 points. And now I use a font that is called Boogaloo. So you can see if I double click on the layer, you can see that this is Boogaloo font. And this is a font that I downloaded for free at Google Fonts. Google Fonts is a great place where you can download fonts for free and you can find them on different styles. So if you go to your browser and type Google Fonts, here you can type Boogaloo with double O, sorry, and find that font. Or maybe you can find another one that kind of works for you. So maybe this Rush Buggy works also fine. And now you have this. You already have your expression. So I hope you have enjoyed this tutorial. Thank you very much for watching. See you next time.